Once you have your data loaded up into Google Sheets, the Google spreadsheet editor, you can quickly browse through the shape of the various distributions. So in this particular file, we see a bunch of information. First of all, it's from the American Community Survey from the Census, 2014, table S0201. And it contains all these different counties from all the different states in the U.S. It's not every county, but it's select counties from throughout the United States. And there's a variety of variables, and you can see here's the variable name, in this case households, and I'll take you through a few of the different variables that are here contained in this particular table. So there's a bunch of interesting information in here, but the main thing that I want to point out is that if we pick any column, this is all the data for a particular variable, and this is the name of the variable, in this case population 25 years and over that have a bachelor's degree. If we select that column, we can very quickly preview the shape of that histogram or distribution using this button here, Insert Chart. And you can also find it via the Insert menu under Chart. So I'm going to go ahead and choose to insert chart. And at this point, all it's really doing is it's giving me a preview of several different charts. And by default, it selected histogram, and here we can see the histogram over here. So we can use that down below here as a cancel button off screen. I'm going to go ahead and hit cancel and get rid of that. And then let's take a look at a couple of other variables and what their distributions look like. So I'm going to go ahead and click here. So there is an interesting distribution. And let's take a look at another one here. So this guy looks a little bit more normal. And let's take a look at another one here. This distribution does not look normal at all. And that's the point of this exercise, is that if you can take data and pull it into Google Sheets, it's very easy to quickly look at a bunch of different variables and get a sense of what their distribution looks like. If you feel like you need to perform normal calculations on data, you should be performing those calculations on data that is at least nearly normal. And in the case of this particular distribution, the data is not nearly normal. But here's the nice thing. By using something like Google Sheets and looking at a variety of distributions very quickly, being able to preview what they look like, we get a sense of whether or not we can use normal calculations on the data that we're working with. Now, if you want to pick a particular distribution and you want to insert the chart, you can tweak the look of the chart a little bit. So, like in this particular case, I'll go ahead and down below is an insert button. Oh, actually, let's look at customization first. With customization, one thing I can do is I can change the bucket size or the bin size in the histogram. It's also known as class size. Here we can see that the class size goes from 0 to 1.5, 1.5 to 3. So the current bucket size is about 1.5 for this particular histogram. I'm going to change it to 5. And let's take a look and see. You can see that changes the width of the bins. And if I wanted to, I could probably make the bucket size, let's try to make it smaller, and let's see what that looks like. And there we go, and now we see smaller bars, and that's an option as well. There's a few other things we could do. Off to the side of the histogram, there's a legend. And for histograms, we don't really need a legend. So I'm going to go ahead and come down here and see if we can find where the legend is. And let's see if we can get rid of that. Here we go. It says legend is on the right. I'm going to choose none, and that gets rid of the legend over here. And the other thing is we might want to clean some things up. So I'm going to go ahead. Down below is an insert button. I'll go ahead and hit insert. And when I do, I can clean this up a little bit more. I can go ahead and click on the title, and I can change that to a neater title if I wanted to. Walked to work. And I could go ahead and change this text or get rid of it altogether if I decided to. And let's see what that looks like. There we go. So this is a nice clean histogram if my teacher was asking me to look at data and then pull it into a report, either in PowerPoint or Microsoft Word or one of the Google documents. You could easily clean it up and make it look the way you want. The other thing is under the advanced editing options, you could go back in and change coloring, and there's a whole bunch of things that are worth investigating here under customization. I'm going to go ahead and leave it for now. So that is the lesson on how to use Google Sheets to quickly look through and browse at the shapes of a variety of distributions to get a sense of whether the assumption of normality is appropriate.